in the flesh. We don't wage war according to the flesh. Now this means to us that there is a war. You are in the flesh and there is a war, and you are not supposed to fight it with carnal weapons. We cannot even listen. You see, we can't motivate people to live last and all this. No, no, it's a war. That one is a war. We can't motivate. It's not. After we motivate you, we give you energy. It's like you want to do it, but you can't. Because you don't need it. You don't need it. Carnal weapons. Weapons that are mighty in God. Yes.
Of palace na manda ngulungu.
Let's just read the Bible. Let the Bible speak itself. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God. They are mighty through God. How is our the weapons of our warfare? They are mighty. They are mighty. In God. The weapons of warfare are what? Let's talk, church. The weapons of warfare are how?
Mighty.
I don't want to talk today. It's okay.
Okay.
Now, so, we are in the flesh. That's why the Bible says, we carry this treasure in earthen vessels. In earthen, not
Jesus.
Earthen. Imagine the treasures of God, they're all put in heaven. Glory to Jesus. So much,
Jesus.
Kana, today is. You are too happy, ne?
So was it a cool?
The only thing that I'm supposed to do is to read the Bible. If you read where I said you should keep them, you keep quiet. Did you hear what you said, my son? You are talking because I said you should talk.
For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God.
Okay.
To the pulling down of strongholds.
To the pulling down of strongholds. Can you say strongholds?
Strongholds.
Come on, let's speak loudly. Just say strongholds.
Strongholds.
Read that verse. Continue.
Casting down imaginations.
Paul says, these weapons are used.
Yes, agencies.
To cast down imaginations. What is imagination? You know how to imagine, right? What do you use to imagine? With what?
The mind.
Which means they say battle in the mind. Which means mostly the enemy, the devil, Satan. What he deals with is your mind. Do you know that you can't do anything that you didn't think? You have to think it. It's not like I can just stand here and then the devil says, you need to roll on. I was right. It's called a roll-on. My partner is a roll-on. Sorry, if you are my partner, you are a roll-on. Don't let me say it. Just say it to me, but then I'm going to be sorry. But look, man. Let's say the devil says he comes to you and he says, kill that one. You know what you're going to say to the devil? Fine. Right? Most of the things that you did, that Satan made you to do, he made you to think that, then you did. Because if he didn't touch your mind, you couldn't do it. There is nothing that you can do without thinking it.
Yes.
That's why this internet that you love so much and these things that you are watching there, could be the reason why you don't stop doing what you are doing. Because what actually what the devil wants to do to you is to get you thinking only. And if he can put a thought in you, then you do it. Because you see, that the devil is very tricky. When you kill someone, let me not use that example because I don't think you are killing anybody. You don't even try. When you steal, for an example, if you have a thumb, when you steal, how it happens is that the devil comes to you and you are looking at that speaker there. And you know very well that it's not yours. And the devil tells you that it can be yours. Just take it when nobody is seeing. And now you begin to imagine having the speaker in your home. Then you steal it. When you steal this speaker, and we find you. You get arrested. When you get arrested, and you go to court, even if you say, "My Lord, it was the devil," they are going to say yes. We know it's the devil, but you have to go to jail for allowing the devil. Everybody knows it is the devil causing people to harm people. You still go to jail even after you harm people. They know very well it's Satan. You can't even say in the court of law, "Please pray for me. Please pray for me." They will pray for you. But after, they have to take you inside for obeying the devil. Brother, the devil is not your anchor. He doesn't wear underwear. The devil is not your anchor. Listen to me. Don't kiss the devil. Do not kiss the devil. Some of you you are always star 140 star temptation hash. Always.
Star 140 star
is a limo hash. You call me to tempt me, devil. You know why I'm saying what I've just said? No matter what you are going to do, there's no day that he will stand with you and say, "We did it together." Never. He doesn't play like that. When you are caught alone. That's why he's called the betrayer. That's why he's called the accuser. He will even tell people what he meant you to do. That's the devil for you. After he gave you thoughts, after you enjoyed whatever you were enjoying, he leaves you. And it's between you and God now. That's the devil for you.
Satan
is a controlling spirit. He's controlling through music, controlling through movies, controlling through desires. So I'm saying to you, when we are fighting by God's weapons, what we have to deal with is the way that you are thinking. The way that you are thinking. Listen, that's why I don't like people who are too psychological. People who always have this way of thinking that is not ordered by the scripture. I'm telling you, that's Satan talking. Listen to me. When I'm reading some of your status, I can tell that's Satan talking. It's not like you have revelations or what? It's the devil you see
provide.
And you enjoy those thoughts. Do you know where to get the devil? Now, check him in your mind. Yes, he's trying to send fire everywhere in the wall, everywhere in the phone. Wait. Send fire to the mind. I'm telling you, it's a controlling spirit. He controls through thoughts. He makes you think something. I never mind. The devil can't come to me and say, "Hey, man of God, let's go get him."
I'm
going
to bury him.
From
and I enter into a 3 days. Imagine if Satan appears to you, there's nothing you do. If a witch, if you are sleeping and you see a witch, I'm telling you, it's a fasting week that you are
praying.
Because the moment the enemy appears, now you know how to attack
him.
Yes, that's the way to manifest. Controlling your mind. Someone said to me, when I listen to my what song, someone to talk about music, because you know I listen to music as well. And I can tell you the truth that I'm not only listening to gospel. I want to lie to you in the repeat. Glory to Jesus. I don't want to be preaching about the devil and he's controlling my mind in the back.
Lord.
It's possible to come here and the devil still leads you. He's the tricky. The devil is not this one you're saying, I kill your mother, I kill your angel. It's not that one you are playing games with. He is tricky. Most of you, you know that he wants came, but you don't know how. You know he wants used you, but you don't know how.
We ask who wants 7 years. I guess
he is a deceiver.
Please.
And he was deceiving Daniel, but you are too young to think that will overcome him. He wants even for your Lord. He went even for your Jesus. He was making him to think a lot. He said,
Jesus, come on.
The thing you are doing, some of you don't even play. You just wake up to say, Satan, you don't have power over me. You are playing that, and he doesn't even mind you if you have your mind. If you think that he's that foolish, he has been here for over 2,000 years. He's an experienced devil. And if he's coming for you, he's coming for you. He knows you. Imagine some of you don't even pray 30 minutes. But if this thing that is under my feet, maybe
I'm
too excited. What are the thoughts that you are thinking? Or some of them might be for me. You know, the first time I met the devil, I was in the taxi. And I was thinking something. And I said, hi there. And I was like, oh. He was even giving me a lot. Holy Spirit made me to realize that this is for
me.
I've read a chapter for you here when and this is the Lord Himself. Listen to me. He now asks a question. Who's asking one question? He said, so when you are walking out there, what are people saying I am? That is the spirit of man
controlling.
He wanted to know how are people trying to control what he's doing. That's what he wanted to know. And it seems to me that most of the disciples, they were busy listening to what those people were saying. Because it's like many of them answered that time. Some say you are Elijah,
Jeremiah,
one of the prophets. He was listening to all that. Then he said, so, my disciples, who do you say? Was quiet. There were no hands. I think the first question, they didn't even wait to be awake, they just spoke.
Sometimes
you are too filled with what people say. Now, if you are filled with what people say, it's good if those people are controlled or led by the Lord. Because if he that is controlling you or leading you is led by the certain devil, it means you are led by the devil as well. Now we are looking at the disciples who still have an opportunity to be led by men, even when they are following Jesus. In that verse, that there are answers about who people are saying Jesus is way too much. The second question was answered by Peter.
And
then Peter said, "You are Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus was quiet. He said to
Peter,
that you have just said, let us see you. Flesh and blood didn't
reveal
to you, but my Father
in heaven.
I say to you, that you are Peter. Upon this rock, I shall build my church.
So
I'm not here to be a theologian, by the way. I don't like those things of theology. But it is clear to us that the rock that Jesus was referring to was the revelation that Peter got. But look at this. They were all in an environment where they got controlled by those three spirits at the same time, all of them. Because you see the last part where I've read. He now says to them, I'm going to be crucified.
So how about your materials?
People will kill me and all those things. The Bible says, now Peter, the very same Peter that was now led by God, the very same Peter that got a revelation from God, another revelation in
turn.
And then he says, let me show you something that is a
bit.
Let's go back to that Matthew chapter 16. Don't be angry. Look at this. Okay, let's check 16 first. And Simon Peter answered and said, thou art Christ. Do you see how it happened? Which means Jesus asked a question and it was quiet for some time. Somehow Peter answered. Are we together on that one? Somehow Peter what?
Answered.
But look at the second time when he was about to answer. What the Bible says, he did. That's when he got a revelation from Satan. Look at
how Satan.
Verse 22. Then Peter took him. That means it means Jesus was still talking and talking, and Peter went to stop Jesus from talking. And he says, come here.
What was Allah?
I want to talk to you. So now here, I'm not sure if it was because God revealed something to him, now he was puffed up, or it's because a revelation from Satan makes you to be very puffed up. I've not really prayed to ask the Lord as true. Was he puffed up because now Satan has spoken to him? Because this altar when God has spoken to him. Now Satan spoke to him. Now he goes, he takes Jesus by his
account.
He didn't even wait for the sermon to end. And look at what he said to Jesus. 22. Then Peter took him and began to rebuke him.
Hey.
For the first time in the world, Jesus. By his own disciple. This is the problem when Satan begins to talk to you. When you begin to move with revelations that are satanic.
Hey.
Imagine Peter holding Jesus by the hand
and talking
to him. Have you ever come across a verse like this? Where someone who is a son. Taking the father by the hand. Yeah, my father, I need to talk. I need to correct you. There's something that is not right with you. You see the way you are preaching. I don't know if this is what comes with the voice of the devil in your mind. Okay, this is what he said.
You know what she
said? He said, saying, be it far from thee, Lord. This shall not be done unto thee. That's what he said. They will never. What does Jesus say? Verse 23. But he turned and said unto him, Peter. Okay, let me read the Bible correct. Verse 23. I'm too excited now. Verse 23. But he turned and said unto him, and said unto Peter, get thee behind me, Satan. He's a controlling spirit. He had entered the mind of Peter. He was trying to control what Jesus was doing through Peter. And when we called this a school, we'll be like, it's very possible for the devil to control you. Very. How many of you think that you are very better than Peter? I mean, this is an apostle.
I mean,
let's just talk, me and you too. How many of you could have known that he is the Christ, the Son of the living God, if Jesus was present and he says, so who do you say I am? Which means this guy was, you know, somehow positioned in the way that God could give him revelation. But he was also positioned in the way that the devil can give him a revelation.
Mind your thoughts.
Please mind your thoughts. Look at me, church. Please mind your thoughts. This is tough. I can preach like this and someone is putting a ring in me here. When I'm standing here, my sisters, listen to me. Mind your thoughts. This sense is tough. When you preach a powerful sermon, they are not necessarily saying who he can preach. They are saying only if I can get married to him. Fire. Let that mind burn right now in Jesus' name. Mind your thoughts. My brother, when a sister is sharing here, be careful of what you think. That could be the exact voice of the enemy. Now it's tough when you have said it. The voice of the enemy is the voice of God. Now things are complicated. You see, my Bible says, when you are led by the Spirit of God, it is life. It is what? Which means if what you are thinking, it is all inspired by God. There's going to be life in all areas of your life. Even with what Peter thought, to say you are the Christ, he was given an identity. He was given an authority. Which means when God speaks through you, there's something that happens to your life. Don't you see it, church? When he got a revelation from God, his identity was revealed. There's something that you have when you allow God to lead you, and there's something that you lose when you allow the devil to lead you. You think it's right? But think of a scenario where I say, my son stand up here in this church, and I say, he is Satan in front of all of you. Because now I'm making an example, you can think it's an easy thing, but think of it wherein I say this one. Get behind me, you devil. And all of you are listening. A revelation from Satan. Entertaining thoughts of the devil. I'm just thinking, that's what the Bible says. Meditate. This book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth, dead in and dead out. You must meditate in it so that you observe according to what it says. Therefore, you shall make your way prosperous and you shall have a good success. Joshua 1:8. So the Bible says, think on these things. I just want to take time to think. What are you thinking, Ben? I'm just thinking, trying to explore. It's a controlling spirit.
Controls
thoughts.
Can I get an amen?
If you think the devil has never visited you, visit your mind. Just check your legacy. What do you think about this? Check the other
neighbors.
What do you think about? Suppose it's
only Uti.
There in 2 Corinthians chapter 10, he says,
I was saying, cool. So, according to the speaks of to what end?
Cast down imaginations. What is the highest level of fighting the enemy? When you can resist him in your mind.
Now,
when you face him in your mind, you say, you know, the problem is some of you are thinking that, oh, who prophet is Roboko? You think also maybe, I don't see and I don't think. That's
what
maybe the way I'm waiting when I come to church on Sunday. That's where your problem is. And Lord, I'm saying what you are saying. And it feels to me the way you feel when you see it. I feel the same. The issue is, will you arrest that thought? Some of you must stop this ministry of yours of
phones.
When Jesus called me, he didn't say, I'm calling you to go and work for Sony Ericsson. You are always on your phone, talking to women, only. It's a ministry. How many of you realize that Blake Leppard was playing yesterday? I saw that game, and now in that game, there's this song they play. It says, Wadala, you are calling someone's wife after 10. He said, hey, what is that song saying? But imagine talking to a woman.
About a woman who is mom.
She's not your wife.
I've seen what's going to happen
after 10.
Sexually, I said, below 10.
Like, listen, strong brothers. You're on your phone. I know you nothing much. You're just talking.
I've seen what
you mean. And you view your prophet.
Oh, my prophet. Yeah,
and you look at it.
Yeah, in bed.
What in the heavens? I know if you are sharing, you say, no, I'm sharing God's word. It's fine. But is it only about sharing? Let them dream. And if they see you in their visions, they must never see you after telling their
room.
Anyway, let me leave that one because I'm just talking some of the things that most of you enjoy. It's your full time. They like you do it. You enjoy doing it. And I'm thinking about this worship. She sings here. Don't you sing? I will really get connected. But why don't you talk to this brother, even if he's from church? Why don't you talk to
him?
The messages, they make me think a lot of things. You know, the devil is very. You see, she looks very holy Sunday. She wants God. She wants all of God, right? But once a guy comes after church today and he says, and he looks at you the way I'm looking at you. Watch out the devil. A lot of things that went to time. Is it the one? Oh, you know?
Yeah,
that things they happen. people who are greeting you at church, you come out of that dimension.
You are
asking us.